Welcome to the
Thank you so much.
So one question for you. What is your favorite documentary film? Aside from your own film.
Yeah.
And I subscribe to your YouTube channel. This is morning.
Yeah. It's funny, on YouTube I don't think I've talked much about the films that I like. I love watching documentaries, and it's a film I saw long ago, and it was probably one of the films that got me very excited about documentary. It's a film called Grizzly Man by a filmmaker named Werner Herzog. And it's just a very interesting film. It's about a man who wants to go live with grizzly bears. And it's mostly his own video, because the filmmaker wasn't with him when he went and did that. And I like films like that. I like films that use kind of found footage. It's very different from the style that I am. I like to shoot my own stuff. But I really like that film, and I think it taught me that you can have a lot of drama in real stories. And I think Werner Herzog is a great director.
I just want to ask you, after interviews, do you transcribe the 15-minute interview and then before sorting it? Because it will take time if you just listen. Do you transcribe? What's your workflow?
So a lot of documentary filmmakers transcribe their interviews, write it all down. And before you do that, make sure you're doing it because you know you need to, not just because everyone else does it. If a project has a lot of people and a lot of, an editor that's separate from you, then maybe you need to transcribe so that other people know what you got. But if you're like me and you shoot the interview and you're editing it, you may have a pretty good sense of what happened. I don't need to transcribe my own interviews because I know what's there. And for a 5-minute film, it's short enough that my interviews aren't an hour long, they're 10 minutes, 15 minutes. I can spend 30 minutes and take a 15-minute interview and cut it down to the 2 minutes I normally use. And that's short enough, I don't need to transcribe that. I can just listen and go, that's a good line. With Sriracha, though, I had 15, 20 hours of interview footage, and that was pretty hard to manage. I interviewed a lot of people. I had 40 interviews in the film, and I knew that I would forget what was there. So I had an assistant transcribe interviews, but I also told him he didn't need to transcribe them exactly. Just kind of take notes. Like, I don't need to know exactly what was said. I just need to know what was talked about. And this was useful because, it's useful because in Final Cut you can search for anything in the timeline, and I would put all my interview clips in the timeline. And after we transcribed it, I would rename every clip the whole transcription. Like, normally it makes sense to name a clip something short, like interview with Blake. And I was actually naming every clip, like, Blake says, blah, 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 and it's really long. You can make really long titles in Final Cut. So I would put the whole line in the title, and then you can search for it. So I can just search, like, where was that line? Someone said something about Vietnam. I could search Vietnam, and it would find me the clip. So that was useful for transcribing, but it's not always a necessary part of